Welcome to CyberTech and the Risk Talk. Today, we are very pleased to have Dolev from Paytm Labs. Dolev,
nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. All right, so can you quickly introduce yourself?
Yeah, so I am Dolev. I work at Paytm Labs as the lead security engineer.
Right.
Paytm is one of the largest payment ecosystems today.
Mm-hmm.
Very famous in India, with north of 350 million customers today.
Yeah.
And we basically handle all the security aspects of Paytm, not specifically application, anything from the endpoint to the cloud.
Infrastructure as well. Yeah.
Yeah. Everything that needs security is basically handled by us.
So you're the person that hands out a lot of things, I guess.
Yeah, yeah, pretty much. Yeah.
Okay. So also specifically today's topics about secure DevOps. So do you have any insight on that one for the DevOps process? How to embed security into that?
Yeah, so secure DevOps is such a big unknown to many companies.
Okay.
I think it's a product of technology that moves really fast and the need for security to keep up with the pace.
Okay.
So it's understood that we cannot just wait for things to happen. We really have to, you know, the general terminology is to shift left, big security very early on.
Right.
And that requires a lot of efforts, a lot of hands,
yeah.
And a lot of delegation to other teams, which are not necessarily security people. You have to delegate security tasks to developers or,
okay.
or resources within development teams to be able to scale it yourself.
Okay, so it feels like everybody needs to participate. And also speed is very important,
yes.
in this case,
yeah.
because nowadays the cycle of development iteration or sprint is very short.
Yeah. So and the bigger the company, the more challenging it is.
Yes, and also not everybody on the same page, right?
Right.
Do you have that kind of feeling?
Security is usually not a priority in many of the companies that I worked for.
Right.
It's usually the case if nothing bad happened.
Okay, afterthought.
Yeah, it's an afterthought, but really the best way is to do a pre-mortem versus a post-mortem and to kind of think ahead what wrong can happen.
Right.
And how can we prevent that from happening? So
okay, so like what you said, push to left, actually push earlier
yeah.
as possible
yeah.
to forecast or predict the problems.
Right, right. And I think the automation part of security in part of the SDLC is also challenging
mm-hmm.
because I feel that automating security can only give you some security angle, but not full coverage or the level of sophistication that you can actually prevent using automation is really depends on who is doing it and
okay.
the knowledge, and it's you know to some
even
degree,
for the same tool
yeah
depends
it
on
really
who
depends
that.
What are you trying to defend from and from who
right
so I think it depends on many variables.
So I guess we need quite a lot of education as well, training, because same tool different people use that may achieve different results.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay, wonderful. And how long have you been in security or like in this technology?
Let's think. Since 2006.
Okay, so quite like about almost like 13.
I've been into computers
right.
even before. I have a fun history with gaming
right.
as well. So
oh,
I
okay.
come from like gaming background
right.
and shifted to do DevOps and
right.
system administration and security.
Okay.
Coming from infrastructure background.
Wonderful. Are there any like interesting stories or most memorable moment in your career?
There isn't one specifically. I think transitioning to the role that I currently am in was a serious thing that happened really fast.
Right.
I think that's one of the most satisfying things that happened for me.
Okay.
A lot of responsibility, you know, large scale, and really coming up with creative ways to keep up with the technology in such
okay.
a huge organization
right.
with a relatively small team. I think that's a very challenging and satisfying. It's not a moment; it's just a satisfying thing.
Right. So there are so many things to learn,
yeah.
so many new things,
right.
and a fast pace.
Yeah.
Right? So every day you probably have a lot of exciting things.
Yeah. Yeah.
Although stressful, for sure.
For
right?
sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
And also, I know you wrote a book. Is that something like
CLX? Yeah, I co-authored a book.
Yeah.
Called Canadian Cybersecurity 2018 with a few other folks.
Yeah.
who know a lot more than me.
Right.
And each and every one of us contributed some kind of different angles of
perspectives. Okay. What did you put there?
So I give, I think, more of a technical aspect to security, a little bit about zero trust and handling breaches and communications when bad things happen, and how should companies prepare for, you know, something that is probably going to happen to some degree, might be worse, might be.
Okay. Because I also read that book already. So I can see a lot of content from governance, strategy, different program management perspective, and you're from more on the technology side perspective.
Yeah, that was the purpose of bringing me on,
yeah.
to give a little bit more, not hands-on, it's not a hands-on book, but to give more insight into the technical aspect.
Wonderful. And as far as I know, you're also the lead for DEFCON in
that's
Toronto.
True. That's
yeah.
true. Yeah, I found DEFCON, you know, the probably a few days after I landed in Toronto when I just moved here.
Okay.
You know, looked up DEFCON Toronto, that thing doesn't
that
didn't
that,
exist.
That was one. Yeah,
yeah, it didn't exist.
Yeah.
And, you know, coming to Toronto without anybody except myself, it was challenging to find a way to meet people.
Okay.
It's easy when you're younger, tougher when you're older. So I thought, why not start something related to security? And, you know, it will help me reach out to the right people.
So there'll be a lot of on the offensive security, like a penetration test.
Yeah,
so
I think the difference between DEFCON and like other meetup groups is that we don't have necessarily a lot of focus on a specific security domain,
right.
but it's more about what kind of hands-on things or workshops or like more hands-on rather than anything else. But we do have other things, like we have lawyers and
people want to,
you know, C-levels coming and giving their thoughts, so it's not only hands-on, but we're known as a hands-on kind of
thing. Wonderful. And as you know, we from the cyber tech and risk, so a lot of commonality there. So we have people care. One side is technology, the other side is a risk. So when you combine those together, a lot of time is cybersecurity.
Mm-hmm.
So do you have any like tips or things you want to say to cyber tech and risk people?
I guess I can start with the newcomers, people who are just starting the journey, maybe lost. Where should they start?
Right.
I think one of the first steps is to really understand what security has to offer before jumping into I want to do A or B or C. Really understand what does it mean?
Right.
What does application security mean? What does mobile security mean
before
wanting something?
The concept.
Yeah. Understand what is it that you're going for.
Right.
Don't go for cool, go for something that you're actually interested in.
Right.
That's one of the things that I see a lot of people do.
Right.
You know, it's not good or bad, it's just my thought.
Right.
And risk, risk is what drives security. Sometimes, you know, threat modeling is a big aspect of security and has a lot of weight into the prioritization that we give to certain tasks and things like that. On the other hand, the more senior people can also help newcomers embed quicker and provide maybe some mentorship. I think that's very useful today for both sides. When you teach somebody, you always need to learn the topic really well.
Right. That's also our purpose for putting all those programs together at Cyber Tech and Risk, for people to learn, collaborate, and also for people relatively junior, like we call them usually the next generation's talent, to learn from the senior people, to experience the professionals. That's also our purpose.
Yeah, and I think today they have a lot of tools and frameworks and platforms to do that
easily. Yeah, also we need people like you to guide them to find. A lot of times they are probably not aware there's already something there. They try to figure out by themselves, but there's already a framework or the tools to do that.
Yep.
Wonderful. All right, thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Nice talking to you.